14-year-old Reed Borgman plays club hockey, and he was hurt during a game when he and another player fell to the ice.
And while I was falling down, a skate hit my neck and sliced it, and I didn't really know what happened at the time.
Borgman came off the ice, and this is what he and his father saw.
And I was like, oh my God.
It was a close call. Other hockey players have died from similar injuries in rare cases. Providers told the family if the cut was 1 inch over, it could have been fatal.
And it was scary. I mean, I got chills, and I was like, because you think about what could have happened.
Reed went to urgent care and got stitches. He's going to be fine, and even went to homecoming the next night. But his parents say they will require him to wear a neck protector moving forward, and they wonder why it's not a requirement. In a statement earlier this year, USA Hockey said it recommends, but does not require, that all players wear a neck laceration protector, choosing a design that covers as much of the neck area as possible, adding there is sparse data on neck laceration prevalence, severity, and neck laceration protector effectiveness.
Even though it's rare, it's potentially catastrophic.
Dr. Steve Kopp, who previously provided care for a minor league hockey team, says it's worth a discussion.
But I do know that in other countries, they require neck guards for hockey players. And certainly we don't in the United States at the pro.